Here is old Brighton trying to do something about that. In towards Downing.
Yes! God! Yes! Yes! That's tremendous!
What a goal that is! I think actually it was Kieran Clark. Kieran Clark has scored at the far post. Oh my word!
Get in!
What a goal that was for Aston Villa! And Chelsea's hopes of back-to-back victories have been dashed. It was a beautiful ball by Old Brighton towards the far post, and it was nodded in. Where was the marking for Chelsea? And what a thrilling game this is. Kieran Clark has snatched a point for Aston Villa.
Great ball by Marky Albrighton to the far post. He cuts in from the left-hand side, whips it into the far post. Apologies for the lack of, what should I say, professionalism. I don't care. Villa 3-3 and deserve it. What a game in this last 20 minutes. Fantastic game in the Premier League. Never ceases to amaze you, does it?
Well, a few of the Chelsea fans took exception to Stan dancing around. Not surprised about that.
Well, welcome back to Stamford Bridge. What a game we've witnessed here on Sunday Exclusive. An absolute belter. It's finished Chelsea 3, the Villa 3. Villa looked as if they had all 3 points. Then it looked as if they were going home with nought. And there were some big, big performances out there. Who was man of the match? Here comes Stan.
Why? Man of the match on TalkSport. You'll only get all at Sky Sports with Sky, including all 5 channels in high definition.
Right, man of the match, Stan Collymore coming up. There's a bit of an argument going on here at the moment where Chelsea support on the Chelsea man's out of order, out of order. So listen, we'll come back in a moment while Stan sorts them out. A couple of tubes, to be honest. Wouldn't be easy to pick man of the match. Stan's got rid of a few, couple of nutcases. Stan, don't worry, calm down, mate.
I'm not worried at all. I mean, I go to places like Arsenal, Man City, Man United and get loads of stick. Chelsea fans only stood up in this block when they scored the third one. I'm a Villa fan, a proud Villa fan. I've got every right to shout if I want to when Villa score. They only start getting a little bit gobby because they feel that they've lost the game. In terms of man of the match, Al, well, several candidates on both sides, I suppose. But John Terry, what a fantastic finish. Exactly what you want from a captain and a leader going forward. I think the two Villa central defenders, Richard Dunn and James Collins, put in a shift today, as did Nigel Rear-Coker and Stilian Petrov. But I'm going to give it to a man that put in 4 or 5 top-quality saves to keep Aston Villa in the game. Very unlucky with the one that Didier Drogba hit hard and low under his body. A fantastic finish from the Ivorian. Brad Friedel, my man of the match. I've been to Arsenal, had a whole block stand up there and give me loads of pelters. Man City gave me loads of pelters after Nigel de Jong's suggestions early in the season. And as the third goal went in for Chelsea... I love it, Chelsea. Very, very hospitable. Some good old friends I've seen here over many, many years. There's a block to the left. We're right at the top of the stand where Carlo Ancelotti and Gerard Houllier were today. So right at the very back. So you can see the whole stand in front of you. A little section away to the left, about 20, 30. Stand up and start looking at me, giving it the old bird and whatever. I thought, aye, aye. They're on their feet singing for once. And Collymore, you're this, that and the other. So... have some of that commentary. We'll be playing it out later. We don't have to be impartial. I'm a Villa supporter, played for Villa. Don't have to be impartial at all. So I don't know where people saying you need to be impartial, Collymore. Where does it say that in the rule book? I'm a Villa fan. Villa scoring the last minute. What do you expect me to do? Sit there like they do on other stations and show absolutely nothing towards a team I've supported since 7 years of age? Absolute nonsense, Chelsea fans, giving me a little bit of a stick around here in the seats for shouting for Villa to score. Maybe if you took a leaf out of my book and started shouting a bit more for your team like they do at places like Anfield, Old Trafford, etc., etc., you wouldn't get those jibes against you that this is the new library here at Stamford Bridge. Yes!
God!
Yes!